I'm Miyasaka in Osaka University. My presentation title is Importance of dxyorbital and Strong Electron Correlation in Iron-based Superconductors. Today, I'd like to talk about two topics. First topic is a different superconducting phase near antiferromagnetic phase in lanthanum and neodymium 1111 system. The second topic is the change of band structure and orbital capture by phosphorus doping in neodymium 1111 system. These work have been published like this. So generally, one material system has one antiferromagnetic aura and one superconducting phase near a critical point. But 1111 system is unique. This system has three antiferromagnetic phase. This panel shows a phase diagram of hydrogen doped lanthanum 1111 system by Professor Hosono's group. There are two antiferromagnetic phase around hydrogen doping level, S equal 0 and 0.5. And critical transition temperature, TC show a two-domed feature. Lower panel shows our result for lanthanum 1111 phosphorus and arsenic solid solution system. There is another antiferromagnetic phase, FM2, this. And two superconducting phase appear by fluorine doping like this. Professor Kuroki and Usui theoretically demonstrated that this behavior. In their model, there are three antiferromagnetic phase, FM1 around N member, FM2 in phosphorus doped region, FM3 in hydrogen doped region. FM1 and 2 have different type of Fermi surface nesting. Around FM3, the heavy electron doping causes a bad nesting condition, and next nearest neighbor interaction important for this antiferromagnetic order. In the other FM1 and 2 is induced by the Fermi surface nesting in iron phosphorus and iron arsenic Fermi surface state. Iron phosphorus and arsenic system have different Fermi surface. The arsenic system has XY hole Fermi surface around zone corner. This panel shows the hPn dependence of TC. hPn is the height position, nictogen height position from iron layer. When nictogen changes from phosphorus to arsenic, hPn increase and xy from surface appear. The change of site from lanthanum to neodymium induce the increase of hPn and the increase of XY from surface size. The critical transition temperature also increase with nictogen height position in 1111 system. So nictogen height and XY from surface important in this 1111 system. There are several substitution effects for controlling nictogen height and XY frame surface. So in our work, we performed three different site substitution layers and nictogen oxygen site. And we have clarified the global phase diagram controlled by hPn and XY frame surface size. In addition, we have studied ARPS to directly observe XY band with changing HPN. This panel shows a phase diagram of Lansnam 1111 system in our previous work. The horizontal and vertical axis phosphorus doping level and fluorine or hydrogen doping level. The color gradation shows the TC value. In phosphorus doped region, the XDYG film surface have good nesting condition and induce the AFM2 state. With increasing arsenic concentration, nictogen height increase and XY film surface appear like this. And this film surface nesting induce the AFM1 phase. On the other hand, heavily electron doped doping by hydrogen doping cause a bad nesting condition. As explained before, the theoretical study had indicated the next nearest neighbor interaction induced the AFM3. The nearer the three anti-ferromagnetic phase, three different superconducting phase, indicating that these antiferromagnetic fluctuations are related with the, these superconductivity. So next, we try to further increase nictogen height and XY film surface size by antimony doping. This panel shows the temperature dependence of resistivity in antimony doping doped Lansnam 1111 system with various fluorine and hydrogen doping level. The arsenic end member with fluorine 14 and hydrogen 25% are located in the TC suppression region in this phase diagram. But we observe the rapid enhancement of TC in this by antimony doping around this region, indicating that SC1 and SC3 states are stabilized by antimony doping. Using this result, we made an extended phase diagram. The horizontal axis phosphorus and antimony doping level. Antimony doping increase hPn and stabilize the XY film surface like this. This effect induces the enhancement of spin fluctuation related with XY orbital. As a result, SC1 and SC3 stabilize and merge in antimony doped region. The right panel shows a phase diagram of neodymium, phosphorus and fluorine or hydrogen doped neodymium 1111 system. Neodymium 1111 system has a larger hPn value and a larger XY film surface than lanthanum 1111 system. So in this system, SC1 and SC3 phase are stabilized without antimony doping. And there is a wide superconducting region like this. This result indicates that the XY orbital is important for SC1 and SC3 phase. And this SC1 and SC3 phase have the same origin. Iron arsenic system has stronger electron correlation effect than iron phosphorus one. So strong electron correlation effect may be essentially important for these SC1 and SC3 phase. In both systems, the SC2 phase exists in only in the low fluorine doped region. The heavy electron doping causes a bad nesting condition, and destabilize the superconductivity. These results indicate that the origin of SC2 is related with XGY film surface nesting. And these results suggest the change of XY band by phosphorus doping in this system. So at the next step, we have confirmed the change of XY band using ARPES measurement in this region in neodymium 1111 system. We measure ARPES spectra for neodymium 1111 system with various phosphorus doping level using beam line at UBSO facility in Institute for Molecular Science, Japan. In this ARPES measurement, we use the polarized incident light, such as P and S polarization, like this. Due to the matrix element effect, we can detect the orbital character of band using a P and S polarization, like this. And the XY orbital band can be observed in the S polarization geometry, like this. By ARPES measurement, we observe the film surface and band dispersion in the folded Brillouin zone, this area, blue area, and the XY film surface around zone corner in unfolded Brillouin zone can be observed at the center in ARPES. And the hole and electron film surface are observed at the zone center and zone corner. This panel shows the film surface mapping, the P and S polarization configuration for various phosphorus doped neodymium 1111 system. We observed the several hole film surface around zone center and electron film surface around zone corner. Next, I show the band dispersion only around zone center for this sample, these two samples to discuss the XY band. First, I show the result for in the arsen end member located in the H1 and 3 phase. This panel shows the ARPES intensity and the second derivative plot on the plane of momentum versus binding energy using P and S polarization light. In P polarization configuration, there are two bands, alpha 3 with G square and alpha 1 with XG orbital character. And on the other hand, we observe the YG and XY band alpha 2 and gamma. In addition, we found small band dispersion very near Fermi level in S polarization. The energy, this energy is the same as the alpha 1 band top. So we think the orbital character of alpha 1 band changes from the XG to XY only around band top. This panel shows the schematic band structure. These XY band incipient and don't make the film surface. So this result suggests that in SC1 state in low fluorine doping level, electron correlation may be important.
Dr. Miyasaka, we have a minute.
Okay. This is the last panel. So next, I show the alpha is a highly phosphorus doped region, x equal 0.6 in SC2. In P and S polarization, we observe the alpha 1, alpha 2, alpha 3, and gamma band. So the YG and XG and YG band cross the frame level. So these bands make the frame surface. So the result, these results indicate that XG YG frame surface nesting is important for SC2 phase. Okay, time's up. So I only show my conclusion. Thank you for your attention.